Have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me, yeah, I don't cry no more. I don't look to the sky no more. Cause I got it on me. I got it on me. I got it on me. You can run up if you want.
What you talking about? Look, it's possible. Know me, kick two fours like I'm Kobe. As you riding or you hiding, if you sliding and you owe me. Run up, catch Kofi, act tough to call police. I don't make friends, yeah, I make bids. Want some rape bids or some OG. This AR be my trophy. Shoot first, shoot back. Oh, none, boo back. Automatic when a woo clap. Shoot first, shoot back. Oh, none, boo back. Automatic when a woo clap.
Have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me, yeah, I don't cry no more. I don't look to the sky no more. Cause I got it on me. I got it on me. I got it on me. You can run up if you want.
50 shots up in his back, I won't let up. HD, going Beretta. Shoot first, you do yourself a favor. Report like I'm Craig Sager. That guy, we been with the bluffing. Dread Bull, shoot you for nothing. 10 toes on your block like I'm drumming. SK, I have a blink, he's running.
Pop smoke, it's that from the floor, shit right back. And I don't politic, cause they ain't like that. I drop a slip or two and get a light pack. And I don't care if you lose, it's still fight back. On me.
This is the Talkin' Sports Podcast, episode number 12, and I'm your host, Peter DiBiasi. Today, we have another great interview. We are joined by Virginia Tech quarterback commit Tahj Bullock from New Jersey. He's a 6'4", 223-pound quarterback from St. Peter's Prep. Throughout the recruiting process, he has received offers from some pretty notable schools, including Virginia Tech, which he committed to, Boston College, Duke, Rutgers, Syracuse, Temple, and UCLA. Thank you for coming on the podcast, man.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, appreciate you having me. Football as well.
Okay, before we start the questions, just everybody remember, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. We appreciate it. We just hit 200 subscribers, so keep that subscriber count going. Also, follow our Twitter account, which will also be in the description below. And quick shout-out to John Rocco Trumpbour, who's also a big part of the Talkin' Sports family. He does all the editing for our videos. So, man, let's jump right into the interview. Let's get some questions going here.
Gotcha.
Okay, so first question. You received an offer from Virginia Tech on May 21st. Less than a month later, you committed to Virginia Tech. What stood out and impressed you about the program that made you commit so quickly?
Well, definitely I know about of the lineage of the quarterback that's been through there and everything like that. You know, overall, you know, I just thought it was the best fit for me. You know, I had a lot of great opportunities, but, you know, a lot of things played into it. You know, the academics, of course, you know, proximity. I mean, it wasn't that big a deal, but proximity for my parents, you know, to make games, stuff like that. I mean, there's a lot of things to put into it. So, I mean, overall, I just thought it was the best place for me, on the field, off the field. I thought it set me up for the rest of my life. I just thought it was a great chance for me.
And because of the pandemic, you never got to – have you officially visited the campus yet, or have you just done, like, a virtual tour? What have you done, like, to, for this?
Yeah. So, I actually went down with my parents. You know, it was a dead period and everything going on, so I didn't get to, like, meet with coaches or anything like that. But I actually got to just tour the campus with my family. You know, you got to see it, get a good feel for it, the atmosphere and everything like that up there in Blacksburg. You know, I liked it a lot. My parents liked it. You know, we just had a good time. I mean, it was good.
What did you think of the campus? You like it?
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I mean, a lot of people say it's a football town. I definitely saw that for sure. So, I mean, it was good. It was good.
Yeah, I don't personally go to Virginia Tech. I go to Providence College. I've been to a couple games there. I've been to the campus. My mom went there. It's a great campus. It's a cool look. It's a much different than some other campuses around the country.
No doubt. Yeah, it was good.
Okay, so keeping on the Virginia Tech and kind of recruiting thing. So what coach at Virginia Tech had, like, the biggest impact on your recruiting? Like, who pushed for the hardest and who was, like, their biggest recruiter towards you?
So, I mean, it's been constant, like, communication as far as, like, Zoom calls and just building that relationship with Coach Corn and Coach Foose. I mean, both of them play, like, a pretty big role. I mean, it was pretty constant since the day they offered me. You know, they just hopping on Zoom meetings. I mean, talking about anything from the academics to the campus life, the football, of course, you know, just everything at Tech and what they're all about. So, I mean, it was all good. And, you know, I even got to build a relationship with some other guys on the staff, some players, some recruits. I mean, I'm talking to everybody for the most part.
And did they talk about, like, planning on you getting on campus, like, in this fall for hopefully we have some games. Like, is that in your future plans?
Oh yeah, no doubt. You know, it's up in the air right now. You don't have any set dates or anything like that. Or, you know, we don't know what's gonna happen. But for sure, that's definitely my plan, to get down there, see a game. You know, just get an official visit, hopefully. So I mean, yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
And you want to maybe elaborate more on like relationship with Coach Fuente? I know he's obviously, everybody knows he's the head coach. But you can, like, give me a couple opinions on him. Like, how's he as a guy? How's like you talking to him? Just a little something about him.
Coach Fu's a great dude. You know, I definitely could tell he cares a lot about his players. He cares a lot about his family. He just and he wants the best for his guys. I mean, I could tell that. You know, that's what played into my decision as well. You know, just building that great relationship with Coach Fu. I mean, he showed nothing but love to me and my family. So I mean, it's been real good. Just been relationship with him, just seeing where his head's at. And you know, I look forward to even getting deeper into it. And you know, relationship with him and his family as well. So I mean, it's been good with Coach Fu.
Yeah, because you committed really quickly after they offered you. So you must have had – something must have sparked your interest in the school, which is a good thing.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, no, I love the program. I mean, it was definitely a hard decision, definitely the most hard decision I had to make in my life. You know, just like I said, just the best overall decision for me, best place for me. Yeah.
And I know you're a hard commit, so you're committed, but any, like – chance of you leaving the school, not like leaving the school, but like telling them like you're decommitting, or is it you're officially not officially Virginia Tech, but basically up in your head?
No, definitely no. I mean, I'm committed for sure. Like, I'm committed 100%. You know, I have no plans of decommitting or anything like that, but you know, I'm in a great place right now. I mean, I'm blessed to be where I'm at. You know, I think I'm in a great place, like I said. So, I mean, I built a great relationship with a lot of people, and all the VTech staff, I mean, players, recruits, like I said, I mean, I'm in a great place. So, I mean, everything's good.
That's great, man. Okay, so, like, we know, everybody knows if you followed you recruiting, you're from New Jersey.
Right.
And you were linked to Rutgers for a very long time. Mm-hmm. Was your interest high with the program, or was it just like speculation of where, because you're from New Jersey, that you were linked to them?
No. I built a great, like I said, this is the hardest decision I had to make in my life, you know. Rutgers, they've showed me love a lot since the new staff got there, Cosciano, Coach Glee, and all those guys. So, I mean, it's been nothing but love with them as well. And, I mean, I'm appreciative that they even reached out and, like, took the time to even build a relationship with me. So, I mean, with my family as well. So, I mean, RU, they definitely showed a lot of love. You know, it was, like I said, a hard decision for me. But I had to respectfully call them, you know, just let them know. I think VTech was the place for me.
Yeah, I don't even want to dive into it. What was, like, that conversation with them? Basically telling them they were really high up. So what was like your conversation with them, telling them that you're kind of going in a different direction?
Yeah, I mean, definitely difficult, you know, but respectfully, as a man, you want to reach out and just tell them, I appreciate their time, you know, the relationship I built with them, you know, that's something you can't get back. I mean, definitely, the relationship I built with them is bigger than football, because that's what it is. And I appreciate everything they've done for me. So, I mean, it was a hard call, you know. Just sat there, talked to Cosciano, Coach Glee, even some other guys on the staff, Coach Augie, Coach Nunn. I mean, I just reached out to all of them, you know. I told them I thank you for everything they've done for me and my family. I appreciate the opportunity they give me and the relationship, most importantly, I built them.
And you being from New Jersey, how far away are you actually from Rutgers?
Rutgers is in New Brunswick, so I'm about, like, 45 minutes.
I mean, you said your parents want to come watch you. That would have been nice and easy. But, everybody's happy you're in Blacksburg.
Yeah. No, I'm happy. So, I mean, I'm good. I'm in a great place. Like I said, I'm in a great place. So, yeah.
Okay. So, like I said, mentioned earlier, you had an offer from UCLA. They were high up on your list, not as high up as Rutgers and Virginia Tech, what I've read. Also, what was your conversation like with, like, Chip Kelly and everybody on the UCLA staff? Just kind of dive into that whole you and UCLA.
So, I mean, I reached out to like every school that recruited me for the most part, and just told them, respectfully called them, you know, just let them know what was going on. And that call I had with Coach Kelly and everything like that, I mean, I've been in constant contact with UCLA and their staff as well. So, I mean, call with Coach Kelly, you know, he respected my decision and everything like that. Respected my decision. You know, we talked about just life, everything like that, was best for me, like I said. I mean, it was good talking to him, you know, just it's something you had to do. You got to call him and just let him know where you're at and anything like that. And hopefully they respect your decision. They definitely did. So, I mean, yeah.
Yeah, did you have any – I know Chip Kelly, everybody knows he's a former NFL coach for the Eagles and the 49ers, which is a really cool thing. Did you have conversations with him before you decided to commit to Virginia Tech?
Oh, yeah, no doubt. You know, I was hopping on a Zoom call with their entire staff, Coach Bible, everybody for the most part. And we just talk about everything I'm doing with VTech as well, you know, because the pandemic, I mean, it set me back a lot, like, as far as getting out to school and seeing the campus and everything like that. So, I mean, I was hopping on constant Zoom calls with every school, every opportunity I had, you know, and just talking ball, like I said, academics, campus life, everything. So, I mean, I've done that at a lot of schools. And, definitely UCLA was one of them. And, I mean, it was just all good, great opportunities, you know.
Yeah. Was there any other school that offered you that you were interested in? Because I read this and not hearing from you because you can give your own personal take. But I know UCLA, Rutgers, and Virginia Tech. That's what I read were your kind of like biggest suitors. Was there another school that offered you that you were – that was pretty close to – you committing to or that you were really close to?
I mean, like I said, every school I had, every opportunity I had, you know, was in the mix for me. I didn't, like, exclude anyone, you know. I could have went anywhere. I would have been happy. Just, like I said, I was looking for a place I feel comfortable. So, I mean, VTech, for me, is definitely the place. You know, I'm blessed to even be here, have this opportunity, because some guys definitely don't, especially with the pandemic, set a lot of guys back. So, I mean, every school I had, every opportunity, every offer, usually was in the mix for me. You know, I'm just blessed to even have all the schools look at me and build relationships like that.
Okay, so was there a school that you wish offered you? You don't have to answer this if you don't want to, but was there a school that you wish offered you that you were interested in? Like, from, like, maybe when you were more younger, like, a school that you maybe thought about going to but never offered you?
I mean, I never, like, really had, like, I need this offer so I can be here, because I would definitely, like, still have to, like, go see the campus, build a relationship with the coaching staff, everything like that. So, I mean, as far as, like, I need, like, that type of thing with the far as the offer or something like that. I never really had that, but, I mean, yeah.
Was there, like, some – like, a school that maybe you grew up, like, wanting to go to that you were interested in but never offered you, or no?
I liked UNC a lot growing up. I liked UNC. That was just – I wouldn't say my dream school. I just loved their football, stuff like that. But it was all right.
Yeah, because on the last interview, I asked Matthias, like, what was his, like, dream school, like, what he was offered. He said Auburn, and they never offered him. So it's kind of cool to see what some of you guys, like, kind of grew up kind of wanting to go – not wanting to go to, but were interested in, and just sometimes never pans out. And going to Virginia Tech is great. So
Yeah, I'm going to agree with that.
Okay, so kind of keeping on the Matthias thing. So how have you, Matthias Carroll, and some of the other 2021 commits recruited other guys – like, help recruit other guys to come to Tech just to kind of get this recruiting class kind of even better than it already is?
Right. I mean, it's been constant. We all got a group chat and stuff like that. So, I mean, we're talking, you know, guys about the guys who want to come, you know, and join the family, everything like that. So, I mean, I've been reaching out to guys, just letting them know where I'm at, you know, and just seeing how everything's going for them in recruiting. Just building a relationship with those guys as well. Just that's what you got to do. So, I mean, we're all working to get, like, guys who are definitely interested and who want to be here and want to play here, for sure. So, I mean, it's been good. It's been good.
Yeah, because on Twitter, I've seen Matthias kind of, like, tweet out a couple guys, like Nachman Brown, who's committing in a couple days, Tyler Williams, who mentioned Virginia Tech in his top six, who was from Virginia. So, Twitter's a huge thing to kind of grow the Virginia Tech class. So,
Definitely.
Also, I don't really know if you want to answer this, but I know Demetrius Davis Jr., I'm assuming you know who he is, how he committed from Virginia Tech a couple weeks ago. Did that have a factor into you committing to Virginia Tech, or was it like that no factor? If he was there, you would still commit, or if he wasn't there, you maybe went into a different direction?
I couldn't tell you. You know, it didn't happen, so, I mean, I couldn't even tell you. But definitely, you know, he did what's best for him. You know, like I said, right now, at this point in time, can't really look at what happened in the past. But I'm just doing what's best for me. So, I mean, he's all good where he's at. You know, I'm in a great place as well. So, I mean, I'm not going to hate on anybody or anything like that. But, yeah, I'm just doing what's best for me. So, I mean, I'm good.
Perfect answer. Okay, so, you know, but you're a state champion in New Jersey. So, what was it like winning a state championship, and how are you preparing for this upcoming fall season?
Yeah, no doubt. So, I mean, the pandemic definitely set us back. That we would definitely be on the field right now. But I've been working, you know. I've been working up my workout regimen, you know. And then we got, like, an app where as far as, like, the lifts and schedules and, like, workouts, everything we got to do like that. And then, you know, we got a group chat too. So, we're all keeping in contact, everyone pushing each other. I've been hitting my guys up, just work out here and there, just get it in. So, I mean, it's been good for me so far. You know, when I get back, I don't want no drop off. So, I mean, it's been good. But far as like last season, you know, it's in the past now. We're just focused on this upcoming season, and we're just trying to get to it.
Yeah, so that state championship is really kind of a cool thing. I know you don't want to talk, obviously it's in the past and you got to move on because that's
what. Nah, yeah, I got you. It's good.
As an athlete, but like just that feeling of winning a state championship.
You know, it was definitely a great feeling. You know, I'm blessed to even be able to compete there with my guys. You know, we all had fun. We all enjoyed it. We all balled out. We got that chip for the prep, you know. And how hard we all worked last year, I mean, I couldn't even tell you. I mean, we all pushed each other so much. And just the love we all play with, you know, we all loved being around each other, just going after it and go getting it. I mean, it was great. It was really good. So, I mean, it was definitely a great opportunity. And as far as, like, everyone's doing good, bigger and better things right now. So, I mean, we're all just looking forward to just building and repeating and, you know, just getting better.
Okay, so on 24/7 Sports, you're listed as a dual threat quarterback. So, like, what is, like, your kind of style of play and who do you play similar to and, like, who do you look up at your position?
Yeah, I mean, I look up to a lot of guys. You know, you definitely got Lamar Jackson, you got Deshaun Watson, Cam, and then you got guys like Aaron Rodgers. I mean, I look at a lot of guys. But I would say Deshaun Watson, I definitely like resemble my game after his, you know, just being able to do with his arm, do with his feet, and just do anything he can for his team. I love the way he plays. I mean, I really see that, his game and my game.
Do you see yourself more as a run-first kind of quarterback or more of just a pass-first? Or you can basically a quarterback that can do anything. Like, if you need to take off, you can take off, but you're not going to take off immediately if the play doesn't break down, so.
I mean, just extending plays, you do whatever you got to do for your team. So, like I said, I mean, I want to do whatever I can. You know, I'm able to do it with my feet if I got to. So, I mean, if I got to run, I love to do it. If I got to throw, I love to do it. So, I mean, I want to stay in pocket, you know, just move, push the ball downfield with my arm. But then when I got to extend plays with my feet, you know, I have no problem doing it. I love doing it. So, I mean, it's all good.
Yeah. Touching on kind of some former Virginia Tech quarterbacks, have you watched any, like, tape on, like, obviously, like, Jared Evans, Tyrod Taylor, and if you go way back, Michael Vick, who's probably one of the greatest dual threat quarterbacks ever.
Yeah, definitely. I've definitely seen Mike Vick here for sure. I've even been watching guys these past couple seasons, Hendon Hooker, Quincy. I mean, I've been watching everything. So, I mean, it's been all good just seeing how those guys operate, how those guys have been utilized these last couple years. So, I mean, it's been good.
Yeah, like I said, Michael Vick, probably the greatest dual threat quarterback. So, that's probably somebody – probably a good person to watch.
Yeah, no doubt.
Okay, so kind of keeping on your quarterback thing. So what would you say your strengths are as a quarterback, and maybe what's something you want to improve on?
Strengths, you know, like I said, just being that dual threat that could do with his arm, do with his feet, you know. And I just love just getting better, you know, pushing my guys, you know, just not quitting. You can't quit at all. So, I mean, that's something I emphasize in my own game. You know, I try to just – push through any situation. You know, you might have seen like the comeback stuff like that this year, but that wasn't all me though. I mean, it was the whole team. I mean, all our guys. So I mean, just staying calm, just getting through any situation with my guys. You know, and you know, just pushing those guys around me, just get better, just keep working. You can't stop. So I mean, that's something I really emphasize in my game.
And what about like something you want to work on? Like, is it your deep accuracy, overall accuracy? Staying in the pocket, because I know I'm not a quarterback, never was really – I'm okay at throwing the ball, but not besides the point. But, like, I'm assuming, yeah, like, accuracy is a pretty tough thing in your game, especially deep accuracy. So, like, what was your big – what do you want to work on? Maybe reading defenses, something like that.
Yeah, I mean, I would say, like, I've been emphasizing this whole entire offseason so far, just standing tall in the pocket, because, like, sometimes I get wide, like, too wide of a base, you know, and that, like, messes up the accuracy, actually, and the power behind your throws. So, I mean, just standing tall in the pocket when I'm getting ready to throw. And then, like, when I extend those plays and I'm outside the pocket on the move and stuff like that, just get my shoulders downhill when I want to throw it, stuff like that. And, yeah, just keep the accuracy, like you said. Just get accuracy. Just keep my shoulders downhill, square.
Yeah, because, yeah, you being a dual threat quarterback at 6'4", you kind of can stay tall. And then maybe a lot of players don't see you. Maybe not expect you to run. Maybe similar. I'm a Bills fan to like Josh Allen, who's a kind of a tall quarterback. You see him drop back, you're like, oh, this guy can't run, and he just takes off downfield. So something similar to that.
Yeah.
Okay. So one final question before we kind of conclude this whole interview. So, what are your thoughts on Enter Sandman? I asked Matthias Carroll last week about it. So, like, what are your thoughts on that? Because I know that's arguably that's probably, in my opinion, the best entrance into all college football. So give me your opinion on that.
Just if I leave like a few words about it, just be like just energetic, amped up, you know, just bringing the juice, I guess. You know, just when just watching it, watching the vid, you know, just thinking of what it'd be like to be there. I can't even tell you. When I get the opportunity to just walk out the stadium like that, to that sound, everything like that, that I think it's gonna be an amazing feeling, you know. And just that's something to, like, just look forward to, and it'll get you amped up and juiced up and ready for the game. You know, it just brings energy to you.
Awesome, man. Yeah, Andrew, I've been there a couple of times. Enter Sandman, it's a fun thing to go. So I hope you get to experience going to the game in the fall and experiencing that, and then in 2 years experience actually being on the field and walking that long walk into the nice claustrophobic tunnel, and then hearing which is a dope thing to hear.
Yeah, no doubt. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Anything you want to, before we end this interview, anything you want to say to Hokie Nation?
You know, Nah,
man. We're excited to have you. So, man, thank you for coming on.
Yeah, appreciate you having me, no doubt.
Yeah, okay, guys. So this was the Talking Sports Podcast, episode number 12. We had Tahj Bullock on for an amazing interview. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Make sure you follow our Twitter. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Tahj's Instagram will also be, and his Twitter will also be in the description, so make sure you hit him both up. And until next time, this was the Talking Sports Podcast, episode number 12. Thank you.